Hello, Ryan here, aka Mac, and welcome. The roadmap has been updated, so let us take a look at the latest changes. As always, a huge thank you to all of my patrons and channel members. Thank you guys so much for the support. It is truly appreciated. So this week's roadmap kicked off with an update regarding what is going on with Alpha 316 and how CIG are intending to roll it out over the Christmas period. Firstly, they say that the delay in getting 315 out the door limited the amount of time they had to stabilize the netcode for 316. So they branched from the 315 development stream to avoid risking the stability, meaning that we are now operating on the same code base that is on the live servers while they manually integrate some of the 316 features that they deem as low risk, so not likely to cause any issues. So basically, Alpha 316 is targeted to release to live next week with the features that include Area 18's hospital, Dying Star Arena Commander map update, the Gravlev physics rework, and Jumptown 2.0. And then early next year, but we didn't give any dates, they will release a 316.1 patch that contains the derelict spaceships points of interest and laser trip mines tier 0, with the DNA head texture update and mining gadgets being pushed until 317. So personally, I am quite bummed that the derelict space station points of interest are not coming with the initial live release of 316, but I also do think that this is the best option. 316 so far has had a lot of bug fixes, and they are continuing to clean up more bugs that have been plaguing the PU this year. Some very significant bugs that we've all been dealing with since the beginning of the year, to be fair. And with 315, that release was a great build in my opinion that I have been thoroughly enjoying, more so than any build before that. So to take 315 and then improve upon it with more bug fixes, I am completely fine with it. I'm also very grateful that the derelict ships are not being pushed till 317, and we should get them before that, as they are my most anticipated feature of 316. Although the Gravlev vehicle rework has been a major joy and has kept me pretty much entertained for a long time now, but I would rather they maintain the stability and fun that 315 brought than risk losing that over the Christmas period, so we can at least continue to play while the devs take that long deserved break. But of course, that is just my opinion on all of this. So moving on, there are a few more new additions to the progress tracker. Firstly, we have lockable containers that will add the ability for designers to lock entities with either physical or electronic locks, which can then be opened by a key or forced open via cutting, destroying, or hacking the lock. Now, these lockable containers have 41 weeks work with the EUPU team, which kicked off early November and is scheduled to complete mid-August next year. Now, I do suspect that this will be used in a lot of locations, like the derelict spaceships, for looting, but also maybe allowing players to lock their items away. That would be quite nice. Next, we have FPS devices tier 1, which builds on the throwables like grenades and consumables like medpens, to enable CIG to more easily create new items with different effects when used. And this will include the development of deployable devices or items that can be carried around as part of a player's loadout, equipped and then deployed onto a surface. So think along the lines of things like deployable holo shields or personal turret guns, amongst many others. I know they have a lot planned, so it'll be interesting to see what comes first. Now, this feature is with the weapons feature team, who are scheduled to work on this mid-February until the beginning of July. So to finish with, the vehicle tech team has changed from being an upstream team to being a downstream team, as they play more of a reactive role to what other teams need and can only really plan one quarter ahead rather than four quarters like the upstream teams do. So they are keeping their schedule through quarter one, but some of their long-term deliverables are coming off the progress tracker until the time comes around. So with that said, the multi-grid signed distance field capital ship destruction and cockpit button animations have been temporarily removed. So that is this week's roadmap update. Not a good news update on face value, but as I mentioned earlier, I am really grateful to see all of these bug fixes and stability improvements coming in, building on what we have seen with 315, and I am very happy that they are continuing this through 316. So although I am very bummed that 316 firstly was quite a low feature patch, and now those features have been split even more into a 316.1 build for next year and then the rest in 317, as bummed as I am fine that this means more quality of life and for us playing over the holiday break, hopefully this means we'll run into less issues. But on a brighter note, I am very excited that 316 is releasing next week. Anyway, with that said, if you do enjoy my videos, please do consider subscribing and helping the channel to grow. It is very much appreciated as we charge towards that 50,000 subscriber mark. Also, if you want to hang out and watch me play Star Citizen, you're all more than welcome to join me over at twitch.tv/supermacbrother. The link is in the description below and it should be correct and working this time. Today, we're probably going to be messing around more on these Gravlev bikes because they have had a couple of updates since the last stream. I think the speed has been reduced and then increased and stability has been brought in so that they're not shaking around or bouncing around. And we will be testing them on, I think, Hurston, the planet, and Hurston's moons today over on Twitch. Hit that thumbs up if you don't mind. It does do the channel a big favor. And tick that notification bell if you would like to be notified when my videos go live. Again, huge thank you to my patrons and channel members. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.